Let's do it. Yo.
Hello?
How are you?
How's it going?
I'm well. Thank you so much for calling in. We appreciate you.
I appreciate you guys.
Thank you. Thank you. So for our listeners, Satan himself has joined this conversation, and I can speak for me that I am honored to be able to spend this time talking to you. Thank you for being here.
No problem. I'll try not to.
Ready to change the world? I'm sorry?
I'll try not to flip out your listeners.
So for some of our listeners, we had an interaction, I think it was 2 weeks ago. No, it was three, because I had just done my blood over intent, and I was new to everything. I didn't understand anything. The whole reason I did my intent was I heard about it, and I literally had a pull from the center of my chest to it. Like, it's the only way I can describe it. I did it. So I have spent the last 3 weeks engulfing myself and learning and doing my best so that I can bring forth heaven to earth too and help and do my part. So, fair enough to say, though, Satan, my mind is kind of blown with this whole matrix and the symbolism. And it's interesting because the last time you were on and your tone was very direct and punch in your face, and a lot of people need that. And then when I go and I listen to you speak, all I get from you is love. That's all I can feel from everything I've watched and everything I listen to. So please share, take the floor or the phone.
Well, one of the things I wanted to cover was there's really nowhere for anybody to run to. Their religion isn't going to help them. You know, their parents aren't going to help them. Their school's not going to help them. But, you know, the force that they pray to every day is, you know, needs them to make an atonement for their filthy soul as by the book. You know, this is, we've all done shit we're not supposed to do. Whatever it is. They call it a blood atonement for your soul, your filthy soul. And people can't come to grasp that they've made any sins. They don't want to come face to face with that, you know?
Yeah.
To admit that you've done something wrong is like, you know, they're still thinking Jesus had killed himself or whatever, you know, for their sins. And if that was the case, we'd all have heaven on earth right now. And
yes.
I don't see heaven out there. I see people having to get up every day for work. I get up every day for work and do slavery and shit.
Mm-hmm.
So, your creator is watching. There's no question about that. I went from a fucking retard to taking over the universe after doing this blood over intent and publishing it. It turns out our creator is actually watching and taking notes and
taking
names, all that other shit. It's called the Book of Life for a reason. That's because your creator is actually taking names. 144,000 of them. So, this type of shit is hard to swallow. I don't really give a shit what anybody believes. Like I say, the Book of Life is only 144,000 names to steal the elect. The ones who were coming to the Garden of Eden in the first wave. You know, it's that we're the ones who were selfless. Everybody else is zombified. It's not even funny. So, you know, there's no accidents, there's no coincidences. This is by the book. Nobody should be flipped out. There's nothing outrageous about what we're doing. You know, I'll remind you often, everybody knows I only take blood. I don't take money, why? So what can I take from you? I can take your blood, you know, oath that you intend to bring forth heaven and earth. Stand here, you know, in truth, bound in blood with your brethren for their common cause of survival to bring forth heaven and earth and release us all from bonds. As corny as that sounds, you know, it is by the book and all.
Yeah, I think a lot of people don't get it. You know, they see, you know, what we're saying and that we're telling truth about, you know, what this reality is. And they would rather be afraid of it and be scared of the whole blood thing and turn away versus looking at the facts that we're exposing what everything is and trying to tell everybody, you know, where the corruption is and how the corruption is taking place. And yeah, exactly. We look around and we see hell on earth still. You know, this place isn't heaven. but you know, people want to try to say bad things about us, and they don't even know. And so, we're here trying to clear the air, and like I said, you can't escape it. You can't. You cannot escape this.
Now you bow your head in prayer to the black sun. You close your eyes, make a wish for the black sun. You throw a coin into the wishing well for the black sun. Is that everything about everybody is you set up your Christmas tree with the spiral lights around and the candy canes and, you know, and Santa Claus coming in the shit chute into fire and all the movies is the same thing, you know. Pirates of the Caribbean, they got to get to the Fountain of Youth. Every compass is pointing to the heart's desire. It's, you know, you need to be selfless and in your heart to even get through this gate. You know, you can't have any greed or you can't. I don't want anything from anybody. I just want to get everybody eternal life. Passage into the Garden
Thank
of Eden,
you.
You know, bring forth heaven and earth, this type of thing. Yeah? To take something from you, that's illogical. It's called eternal life. How could you charge somebody something for their birthright? This is not about money. Every resource is already out there and ready for us to use for this endeavor. It's just it hasn't hit people. You know, whatever came from this earth that you call a resource, this was given by, you know, the goddess of this earth. And she's coming back and she's, you know, she's taking possession of her domain for the benefit of all. That's her living waters that we're going to be bathing in. It's just your birth into this world through your mother. You're going to be birthed out through this holy of holies. And, you know, people say, why do you got to stand here as Satan? That's kind of funny. All your leaders swear in the Bible, and in there it says, it's my world, 2 Corinthians 4:4. It's pretty obvious, you know? Satan is the good guy. Go look it up. Jesus is the Son, and that's what's going to need to stand here as Satan. I look in the Son, and I just speak my intent. The Son doesn't want to know your confessions or your wishes. He wants to know, what do you intend to do today? I intend to bring forth heaven and earth in your name and release all from bondage. And I'll remind you often, I get all my power from the sun. It's the collective consciousness of the whole. How people are missing this is funny. You go into a church, you place a disc on your tongue. You know, it's a disc, like a disc over it. It's a flat earth plane. It's one side of the light, over the black hole. How people miss this shit is beyond me. Every conversation it'll take you for years to figure out how I took over the universe. And for good reason. Because everybody's a selfish son of a bitch. And I'm selfless.
Yeah. I appreciate that.
What else?
Yeah.
This is your motherfucking birthright. You should be pissed off. This is like the reason you get a Christmas tree to communion and the body and blood of Christ. This is all rubbed in your face. No, I'm sorry. It'll take you for years to catch up. It's like we've got such a far, you know, a far enough ahead advance on this knowledge that, you know, people are still in shock about the idea that they're not floating through space as a monkey spinning in a bowl at 1,000 miles an hour. And there's no way they can even comprehend this shit. So how can they even keep up with us?
No, I was just saying that how people like they can't catch up. Some people just want to be given all the answers, and that's sort of the fucking shitty school system that we have where people are just told something and then they just believe it. And so this stuff that we're telling them, they think it's so unbelievable, so out there that they don't want to believe, and they want to be shown proof, or they want to be told a million times, you know, what do you mean by light holes, black hole? It's like you try explaining it to them and then they still don't get it. And so it's almost, I just sort of just tell people now, just do your blood over intent and let the matrix dissolve around you. Feel it, see what happens, and then all of a sudden it's all going to make sense. Everything we're saying. And if it doesn't, then, you know, and I've never had anybody come tell me, oh yeah, it didn't, or, you know, whatever, or the ones that have, I was like, well, are you pure of heart? Did you really mean it, or did you just do it just because you think you're going to come with us to go somewhere that, you know, you're just escaping from something? And most of the time they say, oh yeah, I just did it just because, I don't know, I just want to be part of the club or whatever. And I was like, well, then you weren't selfless. Go do it again and be selfless. Or they didn't post it, you know, that's another thing too. Some tell me that once they post it up to the internet, that the ethernet, that bam, they feel it. And I try to describe it as it's like you could feel people's energy, you could feel the tingles, you feel the electricity everywhere.
You can feel it because let me be very clear. You can feel it because, you know, I'm standing here with Steve. It's scary. People don't put their blood up. They know for sure. I'm telling you flat out. I'm the motherfucking devil. I don't take money worth of life. Everybody knows you will join me in blood. You know what I mean? I don't take anything from you. That's just kind of funny. You can't beat around it. If you're going to put your blood up, you know that people are going to say, you're putting your blood up against this, with this guy? He's safe? He's the devil? Are you crazy? You know? If you put up your blood after that, you have to really know that you've been hustled. And that, you know, many people will come in the name of Jesus Christ. That's funny. I'm the one true motherfucking Antichrist. You know? It's uncontested. I've been standing here for years on Get the Blood. And people just keep putting more blood up beside me, and that's the correct thing to do. Because it's 144,000 in the Book of Life. It's that. That's all the amount of people that we need to wake up. Your Creator's not heartless for only being that many people in the Book of Life. It's that we need to ignite the fire in everybody's heart. And we got to bring some people back to life. You know what I mean?